эта штука сейчас поедет. Блин, как это круто! Почему все грузовики не такие?
What's up guys, this is the beginning to a new vlog. Basically ended in Jacksonville, went up to New Brunswick, Georgia, sat overnight, and now I got a load Scottsdale, Alabama, going to Elizabeth, New Jersey for Thursday morning. So basically I'm getting paid to drop this trailer tonight. I'm about close to 400 miles away. The load's paying really well. They gotta pay my hotel till Sunday night or Monday morning. Then I'm gonna run that straight through, hold the trailer till Thursday and deliver it. Right now we're on I-16 heading westbound. We're gonna jump on I-16 west, go up 75 north, 59 to Route 11, and that should bring me in Scottsdale. I'm aiming to be there between 10 10:30, depending on traffic around the Atlanta area. But welcome to a new vlog. Please hit that like button, subscribe, and leave a comment. Thank you. So is it pretty important when you have a guy on the side of the road like that? Guys, Scottsdale, Alabama. So we're heading. For the guys that say, I don't take this truck nowhere, I just don't be in the mood to go anywhere.
Are you looking good over there?
That's the town, Scottsboro.
Alright, come on over there. Let this guy get off highway. He's stepping in the kitchen.
loving this open road, man. It's so different from the Northeast. It's good to stretch your legs out a little bit. Get away from that wind assault. Even though it sucks, my AC is not working right now, but that's just life, right? turn light here. Truck route. Shipper here in Scottsboro, Alabama. We gotta figure out how to check in and where they want me to drop this thing. got loaded and hooked up, and now we're rolling back towards New Jersey. About to enter Tennessee any minute now. Spots, man. Sometimes that's what you gotta do if you want cheap fuel.
Wow, man.
Just made it. Better than going to the Pilots, the Flying J's. You go to these small stops, you actually save 10, 20 cents per gallon. That adds up in savings, unless you want to get a free shower. Other than that. But, yeah. Now we're rolling. Jump back on 24 eastbound here. Hills of Tennessee. westbound, 75/40. Last time I came through here, they was taking some pictures of my rig. There's a lady here that I know. She's pretty cool. Oh, no, I might get her put on the scale today. Let's see. I got bypassed. West of the town of Lynchburg, Virginia. Still rolling here. Just being the Pennsylvania border here in a little while, in about an hour or so. Like 81 north towards Harrisburg, and then jump against 283, 30. 30 East 76 and stop by the house. Pennsylvania. About time I'm hitting Pennsylvania. Getting back in my neck of the woods. What a drive, man. A never-ending journey. Goes and goes and goes and goes. Feel like it never ends. Progress. Making progress. Until we get into Jersey. 467 highway robbery. Ridiculous. And that's an understatement.
That's fucking dark.
This delivery is for a Whole Food supermarket, and it's basically store shelvings, and they're building a new store. So I'm bringing this home, and I'm gonna sit till Thursday with it, and then find power-only loads to do in the meanwhile, but I'm being paid to have it sit. My hotels were covered, everything. Really good load from Alabama. But yeah, we're about to pass through Philly here and deal with these knuckleheads rushing on their way to work. They leave the house a half an hour before that time that they gotta get there, and then they expect to get there and they drive like a freaking bunch of assholes. But that's what it is. We're rolling. So we're here passing through Philadelphia. Go over that Walt Whitman Bridge into Jersey, and then I'll be home there in a little while, and then I'll deliver this on Thursday, as I said. What a ride from Alabama. Went through Tennessee. Virginia, West Virginia, Pennsylvania, and now Jersey. I said Tennessee, right? Yeah. Good to get out of the area for a change, you know? Change the scenery, stretch the legs a little bit. Put the motor to the test, you know? I enjoyed the ride, but as you seen in the last vlog, I had a little problem with my air dryer regulator valve, but I was able to change that out with relative ease, so I can't complain. Only thing I'm dealing with now is the engine, the EGTs get a little hot. And I think I figured it out. The manifold, one of the bolts got loose, so it's actually losing boost. That's probably why it's running hot. Let me get it checked out, though. Get my air-to-air checked out. Change my air filters. Make sure the radiator fins are not clogged, but it should be all right. Now that I'm back in the area, it's 33 degrees out. From 28 to 33, it runs a lot cooler now, as you can see. But when I was down in Florida, down that way, man, yeah, she was getting hot on me, man. That's just a show. Summertime, I'm gonna have to get that situated so we won't have any issues moving forward. Got some rough road here, man. Get over it. Yeah, we'll be all right. Literally years ago, maybe like 4 years ago, I had someone take my lug nut covers off, and to this day, I still have a pending case lawsuit. The two clowns said that they necked, they back, they injured, they can't work, they can't sleep. Scam artists, so you gotta watch them. So I got my dash cam and I got all my mirrors, see what's going on, man. And even still, people still sideswipe you. Rushing to go to work. As I said, a bunch of scam artists. Looking for a quick buck. So with a dash cam, that should, when the cop come, just play dumb. Just play dumb. And just listen to what they say. And say, officer, I want to show you something. And just take your camera out. And go to backlog. And just press play. And the look on their face, priceless. Like higher RPMs, but oh shit, she doesn't like to be lugged on the 15 or 14, 15. This thing likes to be in the sweet spot, 16, 50s to 1800 RPM, believe it or not. That's the power band for the B model. Like 27,000 pounds, but still a little weight, but that's not compared to like having 44,000 in the box, 45, you know what I mean? out Thursday. They want this by 6 a.m. Woodcliffe Lake, New Jersey. That's up by New York. By 80-287 Junction. As I said, it's a wholesale food supermarket. It's all shelving for the brand new supermarket.
Heavy shit, huh?
street trip from Alabama to Wickfield State, New Jersey. Signed, sealed, and delivered. If you like this content, please hit the like button. Subscribe and hit that bell notification. Until next time, thanks for watching. Keep the shiny side up.